In this video, I'm going to show you how to go ahead and set up your animated alert inside of Streamlabs. That way, when somebody follows, when somebody donates, their name pops up on screen. So the first thing we're going to do is open up our Streamlabs desktop. We're going to go ahead and select the scene where we're going to want to go ahead and set up our alert. I'm going to select my gameplay scene. And if you've never set up a gameplay scene inside of Streamlabs, I'll leave a link to a video in the description below. So the first thing we're going to want to do is get our animated alert. So for this example, I'm going to utilize streamdesigns.com and I'll put a link in the description of this video. They have tons of animated overlays you can go ahead and choose from. And if you get any one of their packages, it does include animated alerts as well. And for this example, I'm utilizing the Pixel World package, and you can see that it is going to be animated, and it comes here with the alerts, new subscriber, new follower, and it gives you everything that you need. But they have tons of different alerts if you just want to get alerts by themselves. And again, like I mentioned, I'm going to utilize the Pixel World one here, and you're going to see that's going to give us all the ones that we need, new donation, new bits, super chat, new host, new member, for us to go ahead and get this set up today. So once you go ahead and get your animated alerts, you're going to come back here to Streamlabs. Now, one of the things is that Streamlabs does have the option to be able to go ahead and set up alert box directly inside of Streamlabs. However, it does have some limitations as far as the customization that you're able to do. So for this example, we're going to go ahead and utilize StreamElements to go ahead and bring in our alerts into Streamlabs. So once you come to streamelements.com, and again, I'll put a link in the description of this video, you'll get logged in with your Twitch account or your YouTube account, wherever you want to be able to stream and have alerts pop up for. I'm going to utilize Twitch for this example. And now what I'm going to do here is I'm going to come to the left-hand side, select overlay. We're going to select new overlay. And this is going to go ahead and bring us to the editor inside of StreamElements. We'll go ahead and select start. We'll select add widget, alert box. And this is going to go ahead and give us everything that we need to be able to go ahead and get this set up. So we have a follow alert, subscriber alert, tip alert, cheer alert, rate alert. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to set up a few of these because the process is going to be exactly the same. And then you can go ahead and fill out the rest and get it added into Streamlabs. So we'll go ahead and set up the follow alert. So we'll hit this little gear icon. We'll then come here and select change video. We'll select files. This is going to go ahead and take us to where we downloaded our Stream Designs file. So when you download a file from Stream Designs, it's going to come in a zip file just like this. If you're on Windows, you're going to want to extract that zip file, and then it's going to go ahead and create a folder here for you. If you're on Mac, you're going to go ahead and double click, and it's going to create a folder for you here. Now, you may have just got the alerts by themselves, so just be the folder. Like I mentioned, every single package comes with the alerts, the panels, the overlay screens, and the webcam overlays. So I'll come to the alerts, and you'll see here that I'm going to look for new follower. I'm going to hit open. That's going to go ahead and bring it in here into StreamElements. And you want to make sure that if you don't see your alert pop up, you want to make sure that you're utilizing a Chrome browser. For some reason, StreamElements doesn't mix well with like Safari or any of the browser. So again, make sure you're on Chrome to make sure it pops up here just like this. Hit submit. And now we'll see here that we have our alert. So the next thing we want to do is we want to go ahead and emulate this, hit, and we want to hit follower event. We see here that the name is not where it needs to be. So if you got your alerts from Stream Designs, you'll be able to follow this exact steps to be able to get this set up. If you utilize any other alerts, it's going to be a little bit different. So I'm going to come here to where it says text settings. I'm going to click advanced, and here where it says top, all you're going to do is keep that at -175. And then we'll come back here to text. We want to go ahead and change this to be about 40. And now we can go ahead and emulate, do follower event. And you can see here that now it is going to be centered right in the middle here for us. So now we have that in place. Now, what I want to do is I want to change this color to match more my alert. So to be able to do that, we're going to scroll down here on the right, and we're going to see here where it says this color. I'm going to go ahead and look for the color that's kind of as close as possible to what I want. So let's go ahead and emulate again, hit follower. And now you see here that we have something as close as we possibly can to that. So now what we want to do is we want to go ahead and add in the next ones as well. So we'll come here to our tip alert. We'll come here to change video. We'll go ahead and upload another one. Select file. And when you go back to your Stream Designs package, you'll see here that you'll see new donation. Select open. That's going to give us the one that we want here. New donation. We'll submit. And now we have our donation there. And again, you'll follow the same exact steps. You'll come to text, advance. Want to make sure this is at -175. And then here for the color, we can go ahead and make this the color that we want, closer to what our package is looking like. And now when we hit tip event, this should go ahead and give us the right amount. Now I want to go ahead and increase the size of that. So we'll come here to text, come here, and you can select 40, and that's going to give you the right size for that there. And again, you can start seeing the animation that we have. Now you can hear that sound effect that's coming in the background. Now, one of the things that I like to do, I personally prefer to utilize Epidemic Sound to be able to get my sound effects. And the only reason why I use Epidemic Sound is because of the simple fact that it's copyright-free music. Now, the service is not free, but there is a 30-day free trial if you want to go ahead and give it a shot. I'll put a link in the description of this video. But the reason why I utilize them is because all my content is going to be safe. Any music that I utilize on stream, any music that I utilize in my videos, any sound effects that I utilize in my stream or in my videos, it's all going to be protected. So I can go ahead and add my YouTube account. I can add my Facebook, my Twitch, my Kick, my website, my Instagram, my TikTok, and not have to worry about the music that I go ahead and play. And they have over 90,000 sound effects for you to be able to choose from. So I'm going to come here and I'm going to just collect a whoosh sound effect here. So once you're here, you'll come to and say Fireball, you can play it and we can hear it there. So I'm going to go ahead and hit download. I'm going to download the MP3, hit download. That's going to go ahead and save here for me. I'm going to open up that folder. I'm going to make sure that it's on my desktop. And now I'm going to come here back to Stream Elements. I'm going to come here where it says up. I'm going to clear sound, upload a sound. And again, I'm going to make sure that I'm protected. I'm going to select file. I'm going to go to my desktop where I downloaded the Fireball sound. Hit open. Here it is right here. I'm going to submit. All I'm going to do is I'm going to just drop this down to about 30. And now when I go ahead and emulate the tip event, we can see here that now it's going to go ahead and give us that sound, right? So that's what we want to go ahead and set up. So now once we have here our alert set up, you want to continue down the list and set up all the other ones that you have here. And then once you do that, we want to come up to the top, select copy overlay URL. You want to hit save. We'll name this and say alerts for Streamlabs. Hit save. And then we want to copy this overlay URL. We'll come back here to Streamlabs. And now you want to go to the scene where you want to add your alert, come to sources, hit this little plus icon. And once you do that, you're going to see an option here that's going to say browser source. So the first thing here, we'll see here, browser source. We'll select that, add source. This is going to go ahead and pop with a menu. We're going to name this alert box, add source. And now this is going to go ahead and ask you to go ahead and paste the URL here. So we're going to go ahead and highlight this and we're going to paste the URL that we just went ahead and copied over from Stream Elements. We'll keep that there. And now we want to go ahead and have it. We'll go ahead and hit close. And then we can go ahead and adjust this and place this where we want it to be. So let's say this is where I want my alert box to be. So now what's going to happen is that when somebody goes ahead and follows or donates, they're going to go ahead and pop up right here for you. And let's go ahead and run a test here. So I'm going to go run a test. I'm going to go ahead and hit follower at least one or two times. I'm going to come back here to Stream Elements and you're going to see here that now it's going to go ahead and pop up here in Streamlabs. So there it is. You're going to see my animation go ahead and pop up. And it's all going to go ahead and pop up here for us to be able to see. So now you have that set up. So now that you have your alert set up, what you want to do is you want to make sure you have your just chatting scene set up. So your just chatting scene is what's going to allow you to be able to interact with your viewers. And you want to make it look as professional as possible. So go ahead and watch this video right here where I walk you step by step on how to set up a just chatting scene inside of Streamlabs. I'll see you guys in the next video.